Lions coach Jim Schwartz has held the fort, and now the club's starting to respond for him. Five of their last seven will be at home. Started losing three out of four. Special teams failures, particularly against the Vikings, hurt them early. And then Stafford has come alive, and the defense has come alive as well. So this team has improved in just about every area.
Yes, they have. And on the other hand, Leslie Frazier really needs to get his team. What a critical game. 1-3 record versus Detroit. His second year as a head coach. And when you look at the Vikings season, it started off really well. 4-1. Christian Ponder was hot. The rush defense was stopping everybody in sight. Of late, Ponder not. And the rush defense struggling mightily.
No question about that. And this is a tough division, the NFC North. The Bears lead, Green Bay is second. Minnesota, though, only a game behind the Packers in Detroit. This is the only division without a losing record. In fact, every other division has at least two teams with losing marks at this point.
And I tell you what, I love what the National Football League has done in terms of stacking these division games at the midpoint of the season and beyond. It makes for great intrigue, games like this.
Well, to no one's surprise, the Vikings won the toss and deferred. Lions get it first. Blair Walsh kicking off. Stephon Logan is back, and he's going to have a chance to run this one out. And Logan, good coverage, is stopped shy of the 20-yard line. That was a 17-yard return. So Matthew Stafford, who last week became the second fastest NFL quarterback to 10,000 yards, that's in 37 games. And how do you assess his play as the season has moved on,
Joe? Well, you're talking about one of the great arm talents in the National Football League. This kid can throw a football. He knows better than anyone, though. You're judged by wins and losses. He's done that of late. We'll see if he can keep it going.
Lions will start from the 14. Mikel LeSueur. And he is stopped for no gain on the first play of the game by Fred Evans, who's starting at nose tackle. So the Lions, coming into this game, come in as the top-ranked passing team in the league.
And we talked about it in the open. Calvin Johnson, the big star. He's been productive, but it's the run game, led by Mikel LeSueur and Riley Reiff, a backup offensive lineman that has really sparked this offense with his blocking in the run game.
Well, he sure has been a wild card up front for the Lions. Second down and 9. Stafford up the middle, completes to Pettigrew, and a first down. We'll see where they spot it for the Lions at the 25. Gain of 10. Taking a look at the Vikings defense, and they really have been extremely vulnerable against the rush in the last four.
They have, and we're talking about the Lions running the football better. This was a good rush defense early in the year. Of late, the last four games, 100-yard rushers in each of them.
And Riley Reiff, who you talked about, is in the game right now as the extra offensive lineman. And there he is, 71, lining up to the left. And on first and 10, Stafford's pass, and a good catch is made. And it should be another first down for the Lions to Calvin Johnson, an 11-yard pickup.
That's one of the things that the Detroit Lions, they're running more of this package with Riley Reiff in. And Jim Schwartz says, hey, we got to be balanced in that package. It can't be all run. When we have Riley in there, it gives Matthew more time to throw. And when he has time to throw, that happens.
Went over 100 yards for the fourth time this year against Jacksonville with 129 yards. Amazingly, only one touchdown catch this year. Here is LeSueur, and LeSueur getting a couple of yards, and a flag is down. Our first penalty of the game. Fred Evans, the nose tackle, starting in place of LaTroy Guyon, making the tackle. Pete Morelli, today's referee.
Personal foul, unnecessary roughness, illegal crackback block, number 84 of the offense. 15-yard penalty, remains first down.
Rookie wide receiver Ryan Broyles, and that'll move the Lions back.
Ryan Broyles, a player that's been playing good football for the Detroit Lions of late, going to come on the crackback. Get a block in the back of the legs, Antoine Winfield. Good call by the officials, right on it.
Now it'll be first down and 23, an opportunity for the Vikings defense. Right here on the first possession. Quick handoff to LeSueur, and LeSueur runs it out to the 27. Antoine Winfield, the cornerback, coming up in the game of nearly five.
And that's some of the patience we're talking about. Scott Linehan, the offensive coordinator for the Detroit Lions, I think he deserves a lot of credit. Teams come in intent with new game plans every week on taking away Calvin Johnson and his explosive nature. And so what do you do on the flip side? You run it until they come up on Calvin Johnson, then you go up top.
They gained a season high 149 yards rushing against Jacksonville, so that, John, has been their trend. Second and 19. Pressure on Stafford, and this pass intended for Titus Young, thrown away. So third down and long for the Lions coming up, and Young, who's contributed along with the rookie Broyles, with Nate Burleson out for the rest of the year with a broken leg.
And everybody on the Vikings talked to us. They talked about getting off to a fast start. The crowd understands it, and this place gets loud on third down.
And Joint Bell, he's been a welcome contributor. Number 35 is in the game. Good receiver out of the backfield to the right of Stafford. Stafford, and he goes out of the backfield to Bell, and Bell spins away after the initial hit, but will be well short of the first down, and a tackle by Winfield, a pickup of five, and the Vikings hold on the first possession of the game defensively.
And a tremendous job by the Minnesota Vikings. It was the illegal crackback by Broyles that put the Lions in a bad situation, allowed the Vikings to get off the field.
So Nick Harris will be kicking DeMarcus Sherrills. In their first meeting, Sherrills returned a punt 77 yards for a touchdown. We'll return this from the 27. But the Lions are there, and the Sherrills is tackled at about the 33-yard line. So Adrian Peterson and the rest of the Vikings offense ready for their first offensive possession of the game.
Today's game on Fox is sponsored by Southwest Airlines. Find our fares online only at southwest.com.
And welcome back to Minneapolis. And Christian Ponder has been in a slump. Eight interceptions in his last five after none in the first four. And that's only part of the story. From the 33-yard line, Ponder going outside and completes it to Jerome Felton, the fullback. And a gain of 5 yards. The Vikings, well, no question, you mentioned they've got a great one running the ball, but they can't continue to be one-dimensional.
They can. And Adrian Peterson, he's going to get his. You see the 20-plus runs, most in the NFL. 20-plus passes, last in the NFL. Kyle Rudolph, Jerome Simpson, Jarius Wright, the rookie. These are guys that got to come alive for Christian Ponder and the Minnesota Vikings.
They got John Carlson back at tight end. We may see two tight ends at times. And here's the handoff to Peterson. And there's Peterson getting the first down. Out to the 45-yard line, getting 7 yards.
And they call him all day. And I can watch this all day because I got so much respect for this player and what he's done and what he continues to do as a player. This is a running back that injured his knee, his ACL, on December 24th of last year. He's back and he's leading the league in rushing. It's incredible.
It's an amazing story. And here he is again going outside, but the Lions come in, and Kyle Vandenbosch, the defensive end, limits him to two. So taking a look now at the Lions defense, and they have improved, obviously, and it all starts with a talented and forceful defensive line.
It starts up front. There's no doubt about it. They've been really good. I believe they can be great and are going to need to be great up front for them to get where they want to get this year. The secondary, not household names, but they've played very well.
Corey Williams with a knee injury is inactive, and Nick Fairley replacing him on the defensive line. Second down and 8, and they go to Peterson again, and great tackle made by Fairley, who's starting in place of Williams, and not easy to stop Peterson for no gain, and he loses 2 in the process.
Well, and that's the type of plays that I'm talking about. You see Nick Fairley right there in the middle. He's a dynamic player. Well, if you're a dynamic player, you got to be dynamic, not get close, but you got to finish. There's a tackle for loss. And that's dominant football right there. That's what I think they're capable of.
So third and 10, and Jarius Wright active for the first time this year. And a deep pass to Wright. He's got it. Jarius Wright with the catch at the 1 yard line. What an opportunity he has today with Harbin out of there, and he delivers a 54 yard catch.
I'm going to line Jarius right up as the number three receiver. We saw this play in practice on Friday. They didn't complete it. It was overthrown. They got this one, though. Jarius Wright, a burner out of Arkansas. This is a 4-3 guy, and they're going without the huddle down here, trying to sneak one in on the Detroit Lions.
Would you rather complete it in the game or practice?
Let's think
I'll
about
take
it.
The game.
And the Lions call a timeout. So Lions shocked by a 54-yard pass to Jarius Wright, who hasn't worked that much with Ponder and had a big preseason finale. They've been waiting to put this guy in, and didn't take him long to deliver. First and goal. And a flag is thrown, and we'll have a false start penalty against Minnesota.
False start. Number 82 offense. 5 yard penalty remains. First down.
It's on Kyle Rudolph, the tight end.
And we go back to that throw by Christian Ponder. One of the things he's been struggling mightily, he's very uncomfortable in the pocket. He can't wait to get out. But watch there. That's what the great ones do. They sidestep. They step up in the pocket. They buy time. And when you do that, things like this develop.
But the Vikings, with a dead ball foul, lose five. And it is first and goal now from the six. Makes the task a little tougher for Christian Ponder. Hands off to Peterson. Peterson gets to about the three. It'll be second down and goal with Eric Coleman, who's starting at strong safety today for the injured Amari Spivey. And if you're the Vikings and you've been slumping and you're at home in the division rival, you got to get six.
Absolutely. For confidence, to get a lead. You know Matthew Stafford and this offense are so potent. Field goals don't cut it. You got to put touchdowns on the board.
Second and goal. Fake to Peterson. Pass. Touchdown. Jarius Wright. What a debut for Jarius Wright. Fourth round pick from Arkansas, and it's 6-0.
And this is something that's been missing that should be there all day long, because Adrian Peterson garners so much attention. When you fake it to him on the play action, guys like Jarius Wright can slip off to the flat. Beautiful execution. That's been missing. It's back for the Vikings, and they're sure glad it is.
And a 3 yard touchdown toss. Blair Walsh on for the extra point. And the Vikings take an early 7-0 lead. And so Jarius Wright, talk about making the most of his chance. 54-yard catch to set it up. 3 yard touchdown catch. And it's 7-0 Vikings.
Today's game on Fox is sponsored by Jeep Grand Cherokee. By K Jewelers, every kiss begins with K. And by AT&T, the nation's largest 4G network. AT&T, rethink possible.
And back here at the Mall of America Field, a 7-play, 67-yard scoring drive. Wright, in his first game ever, the rookie from Arkansas, taken in the fourth round. First career touchdown, first career catches. Stephon Logan is back deep. And John pointed out, no Harbin, but maybe you can spread it around. And that's certainly what Christian Ponder did. And right now, let's go down to the third member of our team, Jennifer Hale.
Well, Dick, I had a chance to visit with Jarius Wright pregame. One excited young man. He told me he has been fighting those butterflies since last night, trying to act like he's been here. As far as the comparisons to Percy Harbin, he said, you know, the coaches told him you don't have to be Percy. Just be Jarius Wright, and that'll be enough. Clearly, in that first drive, he's proving that, Dick.
No question, Jennifer. I guess being Jarius Wright was enough. So the Lions with a first down at the 20, trailing 7-0. And the pass batted down at the line by Brian Robinson, the defensive end, and it'll be 2nd and 10.
And I tell you what, certain guys just have a knack for knocking the ball down. Brian Robinson has done this 5 times in the last 3 weeks now. You're not going to get there. Get your hands up. It's a timing thing. It looks easy. I promise you, it's not easy. Brian Robinson does it really well.
And Riley Reiff, who was the number one draft pick from Iowa, and we talked about his ability to help the Lions offense has checked in. Second down and 10. They fake to Shore, and this pass incomplete, and it was intended for Titus Young. And defending was A.J. Jefferson, who started his first game last week against Seattle.
This is what we call a glance route. It's a timing route. Titus Young and Matthew Stafford not there on the timing. Good tight contested coverage by A.J. Jefferson, filling in for Chris Cook, who's out for the year. Sets up a big third and 10 for the Detroit Lions.
Kevin Smith checking in the backfield. Pressure on Stafford, slings it, and the pass is intercepted, and it's Chad Greenway. Talk about a start for the Vikings. Chad Greenway with the interception. It was intended for Brandon Pettigrew, and the Vikings have the ball on the 25 of the Lions.
And when we talked to Matthew Stafford yesterday, we asked him, who are the guys you have to look out for on this Minnesota defense? First guy he mentioned, Chad Greenway. He said he's all over the field. Well, there he is, all over the field. Leading tackler in the NFL coming into the game. Tremendous hands as well. Great play by Chad Greenway.
And that's only the fifth interception of the year by the Vikings. And another big opportunity from the 25. Pressure on, and Ponder gets the pass back after it was batted by Cliff Avril. And he is tackled back at the 40, so a 15-yard loss will send the Vikings back to the 40 with second down coming up.
Well, when Christian talked about spreading the ball around, I'm not so sure he's talking about throwing the ball to himself, but this is just an outstanding play by Cliff Avril, getting his hands up, and really, if you're Ponder, you want to knock that ball down, loses a bunch of yards in the process.
So it'll be second and 25, and Jarius Wright is back in the game. Second and 25, and there's the pass out. Wide receiver screen to Jerome Simpson. Simpson picks up about 4 yards, and we'll have our first game break. So let's go out to L.A. and Kurt Menefee.
Well, it's Jerome Simpson's former team, the Bengals, up quickly on the Giants. That's Andy Dalton and hooking up with Andrew Hawkins. 14-0, Bengals have scored in their first two possessions of the ball game. Dickens out.
All right, Kurt, and of course, everyone talking now about the Giants. They looked unbeatable a few weeks ago, and now there are some questions.
We'll be there at the end of the year. Tom Coughlin knows what he's doing up there.
Third down and 23. And here's Ponder, and he completes the pass to Kyle Rudolph, and Rudolph is wrestled down at the 30-yard line. That was an important pass. Doesn't get him a first down, but sets up a field goal try.
Great point. They've got a tremendous kicker in Blair Walsh, the rookie. But you want to help him out. They were sitting at about 55 yards. Now you move it up to a much more makeable field goal for the young man.
This will be a 48-yard attempt, and you're right about Walsh. Rookie from the University of Georgia, and the 48-yard field goal try hugs the left upright, but it's good. And the Vikings take a 10-0 lead, and it was set up by the interception by Greenway. And Minnesota takes the early lead, trying to end the two-game losing streak.
Today's game is sponsored by Bud Light, the official beer of NFL fans. Here we go.
And a 10-0 lead, and the interception by Greenway, and they ended up with a field goal. And Cliff Avril made a good play because the Vikings had the ball on the 25 and might have been looking at a 2-touchdown lead, but it's still 10-0, and the Lions struggling on their first two possessions. And Jim Schwartz talked about the crowd noise and how much that plays a role in this game. Logan will down it there, and the Lions will take it out at the 20.
See the Detroit Lions first in the NFL in yards per game, second in the NFL total offense, pass offense, excuse me, first in the NFL first downs made, second. This is a potent offense. They're struggling early though. The Minnesota Vikings came out to play. Detroit Lions got to step up the game.
And the Vikings always with an eye on number 81, Calvin Johnson. Riley Reif, the offensive lineman, again checking in, and here's the pass to Calvin Johnson, and it's Greenway who's right there. No gain on the play. Greenway playing an inspired first quarter defensively.
And I couldn't agree more with Matthew Stafford about the abilities of Chad Greenway. He's a guy who you'll see all over the field. I think where he's been most impressive to me of late is the aggressive nature, playing downhill. That's Calvin Johnson, one of the great receivers in this league. He's covering him in the slot, man on man. Goes and gets it. Great play by Greenway.
Second and 10. LeSure. And LeSure picking up a few yards. Out all of last year with a ruptured Achilles tendon. Never got a chance to play. Was a second round pick. And a 3 yard gain there. Job at best is lost for the season. And the Lions all of a sudden have a couple of running backs in LeSure and Bell who they can count on.
Story of this game has been third and longs. That's the situation they've been in each of their first two drives. Here we are again.
And Joint Bell is into the game. He's out of Wayne State in Detroit. Third down and 7. Stafford. And unable to hold on is Bell. Bell, one of the better receivers from the league's running backs, couldn't hold on. He had a chance to get some more yardage. So fourth down coming up, and Nick Harris will punt.
Again, Brian Robinson with the good pressure. Joyc Bell had an opportunity at the first down had he caught that, and the sure-handed Joyc Bell typically doesn't catch it there.
Marcus Sherrill's running up and has it at the 45, and he's tackled immediately, but the Lions cover well. Vikings will have good field position after the 32-yard kick. Eric Coleman, who started for Amari Spivey, made the tackle on special teams. He's shaken up, and so Don Carey replaces him at strong safety for the Lions. First and 10 on the Minnesota 46. Another opportunity for the Vikings, and here is Adrian Peterson, who needs 33 yards to go over the 1,000 mark for the fifth time in his career. Stopped at the line by Justin Durant, the outside backer.
We talked about the importance for the Minnesota Vikings to start fast in this game. It was more important for Christian Ponder than I think just about anyone. A lot of pressure on this young man because he's been slumping of late. You see today, 6 of 6, 57 yards. Couldn't ask for a better start.
Should boost his confidence to say the least. Second down and 9. And here's Ponder, can't go left, and now in trouble, and is tackled back, and they will rule the ball down by contact. It was Nick Fairley with his second impressive defensive play in the first sack of the game, and Ponder and the Vikings will lose 7 yards.
You're going to watch Nick Fairley with just relentless effort. Again, I said the Detroit Lions have been a really good defensive line. I think they can be dominant. Nick Fairley trying to make that move from really good to dominant today. He's off to a great start as well.
And you know, John, they put a lot of pressure. They don't have a lot of sacks, but Jim Schwartz says they do put the pressure on the quarterback. Third down and 16, and the pass is incomplete. Jarius Wright, the intended receiver, so the Vikings will have to kick as we check in with Kurt Menefee in a game.
Well, like the Vikings, the Falcons were up 10-0 against the New Orleans Saints. That is until Chris Ivory had this nice run. Not only along the sideline, but check out the stiff arm a little bit later. 56 yards, the longest of his career. He had 48 yards rushing all season before that. It's still an Atlanta lead, 10-7. Dick, John, Jennifer?
All right, thank you very much, Kurt. And a big opportunity. Falcons trying to stay undefeated. It could be a shootout. Chris Cluey will be kicking. Stephon Logan. Fair catch, flag is down at the 18. After the 45-yard kick.
During the kick, holding number 27 of the receiving team. Half of this to the goal, first down.
That'll be on Alphonso Smith. This week, Fox College Saturday begins with a Pac-12 showdown between crosstown rivals as the 19th-ranked USC Trojans take on the 18th-ranked UCLA Bruins. Then the 12th-ranked Oklahoma Sooners square off against the West Virginia Mountaineers. Coverage of Fox College football begins Saturday at 2:30 Eastern, 11:30 Pacific.
That last play, Pete Morelli announced it's Alphonso Smith right there on the hold on the gunner. Tough work out there. Jamarcus Sanford gets taken down by Alphonso Smith. Another good call by the officials.
Lions getting really the short edge of field position. Starting from the 8-yard line, penalty marker down, LeSure with the carry. And he brings it out to the 13. 5-yard gain and another flag.
Offside. Number 97 defense lined up in the neutral zone. 5-yard penalty remains. First down.
So it'll still be first down. Everson Griffin.
Typically, Dick, when they call that lined up in the neutral zone, they've warned you first. They've said, hey, I got to call it on you if you're not in there, if you keep getting up that far forward. And Everson Griffin obviously didn't listen.
There's the average starting field position. Heavily weighted in favor of the Vikings. First down and 5 from the 13. Stafford, and the pass completed to Titus Young, and that will give the Lions a first down.
Titus Young is really a guy who has stepped up for the Detroit Lions. Nate Burleson going out earlier in the year with the injury. As they report, Riley Reiff in the game. But Titus Young had a huge game 2 weeks ago in Seattle. He's a guy Matthew Stafford really likes. Brings some explosion opposite of Calvin Johnson.
Scored a couple of touchdowns in that game. Here is LeSure, who lost his footing and will lose a yard.
Run defense is something that, as we have chronicled, has been going downhill for the Minnesota Vikings. They've been working hard at gap integrity, being where you're supposed to be, when you're supposed to be there, and then tackling, finishing it, and they've done it very well today.
Lions, though, sticking to that run game. Good balance so far. LeSure, in particular, who scored 3 touchdowns against Jacksonville last week. Second down and 11. Play action. And this pass and a terrific catch made by Titus Young for the first down out to the 35. And a 16-yard pickup as the Lions get out of trouble.
And this is a throw that our old colleague Troy Aikman used to make better than anybody in the league. Right now it's Matthew Stafford. These intermediate throws down the middle of the field, the glance routes, nobody throws it better. And that takes arm strength. It takes anticipation. It takes some fearlessness because you're throwing it in the middle of the field, and it takes wide receivers that aren't afraid to take a thumping as well.
And Young caught the game-winning touchdown pass against Seattle. 20 seconds to go as LeSure gets it out to the 39. And it was Winfield along with Greenway combining to make the tackle. LeSure gained 26 yards on 13 carries in the first meeting between these teams, but he was hampered with a groin injury.
Yeah, week 4, Minnesota Vikings threw on the film this week, and Alan Williams and Leslie Frazier, they used it as, this is what we're capable of. This is when they were playing really good football. They put on the film, just let it run, so their guys could see what they were at one point this season.
And John, they had a great week of practice. Second down and 6. Here is Stafford, and the pass is caught by Ryan Broyles, and he has produced. And he catches a 6-yard pass, and that will be the end of the first quarter, with the Vikings leading 10-0. And Fox NFL Sunday will continue after these messages. It'll be a first down at the 45 for the Lions. That's their best position of the game. See what Stafford does with it. And he can't find a receiver and will pick up about 9 yards in the process. So the Vikings had the big edge, John, in field position, and it could only manage the field goal the second time around, and we'll see whether the Lions come back and make them pay for it.
Well, this kind of feels like the Detroit Lions season, this game. It's a microcosm of their season thus far. They dig themselves a hole, and it seems like they're kind of creeping back in it, getting a little rhythm going offensively. On that last play, you see Matthew Stafford break contain. I think a very underrated part of his game. We all look at his arm talent, his arm strength. He can move around very well in addition.
He has scored 3 touchdowns this year, 2nd down and 1. And they're going to run it to Michael LeSure, and he'll burst through for the 1st down into Viking territory to the 40. Robinson brings him down after a pickup of 6.
See the play selection, very balanced. This has been their trend of late. And when you do that, you got to believe you soften them up with the run, and then Calvin Johnson's always lurking out there. And as the Minnesota Vikings said, we can give them some yards. We can't give them the big ones over the top of us.
Johnson has caught 2 for a total of 11 yards. There he is at the top of his screen. A.J. Jefferson defending against him. 1st down for Stafford. Good protection here, and the pass is caught by Johnson. And it's Harrison Smith who brings him down, and finally the Lions unleash their passing game to the tune of 24 yards.
Well, that's exactly what we're talking about. You run enough, you start softening a defense up, and you give holes in your zones for guys like Calvin Johnson. And you put that ball up there, you got such a big body, there's a huge radius that Matthew Stafford can throw to. He knows Calvin's going to go up and catch it. Great execution by the Detroit Lions.
And that was Josh Robinson, the rookie from UCF, who had the initial defense on Calvin Johnson. So a 1st down on the 17 of the Vikings. Here's LeSure. Breaks a tackle, breaks 2. And LeSure bites his way down to the 10. Harrison Smith finally brings him down, and 7 more yards for the hard-running Michael LeSure.
This is where someone on the Minnesota Vikings got to step up and make a play. Early in the game, they're tackling him in the backfield. Now he's starting to break tackles. Remember LeSure, he's 230-plus pounds. That's what he does. He breaks tackles. You better start tackling better if you're the Minnesota Vikings.
Without question, 2nd down and 3. Ball at the 10. Lions fighting back. They go to LeSure again. Why not? And he is tackled behind the line by Winfield. Good penetration by the veteran cornerback in his 14th year. And the Lions and LeSure lose 2 yards.
Inside the red zone. We're talking about situational football. This is where the Detroit Lions have been exceptional of late. 8 straight red zone touchdowns inside the 20-yard line. That's winning football.
And that's over the last 3 games. Scott Linehan would like to see that number go up to 9. It'll be 3rd down and 5. 11th play of the drive. Stafford looking for help, and he's sacked back near the 25 by Kevin Williams. And what a time for the Vikings to get their 1st sack of the game and force the Lions to try the field goal.
We'll give credit to Kevin Williams, but this is a coverage sack all day long. Tough contested. They're doubling Calvin Johnson, as to be expected. And then Kevin Williams comes around, loops around on the TE game, and then finishes Matthew Stafford.
So the ageless Jason Hansen, who has missed just 2 field goals, will try this from 41. Loss of 11 on that last sack. And Jason Hansen, who has made a living kicking indoors, kicks it through, and the Lions finally are on the board. And the score now will be 10-3. Calvin Johnson made the big play with the catch.
Today's game is sponsored by Silver Linings Playbook, starring Bradley Cooper and Jennifer Lawrence, in theaters November 21st. By Pepsi, crack open a Pepsi and live for now. And by Ford and the Go Further with Ford Night.
Well, the Lions had their best opportunity, certainly good field position, but had to settle for a field goal thanks to the pressure by the Vikings. So a 12-play scoring drive, and Stafford was perfect on that drive, and it's now 10-3. Marcus Sherrills is back deep. Percy Harvin returned the opening kickoff the last time these teams played, 105 yards for a touchdown, so they're going to miss that dimension from him today. Here is Sherrills returning from 4 yards in. And good coverage that time by the Lions. And we're going to take a break right now. Don Carey on the special teams tackle, and Christian Ponder goes to work with a 7-point lead. Well, Lions are leading in the game. They have that touchdown, and 4.7 is not bad for an average yards per play. We're starting here from the 14. Ponder getting the pressure and dropping it is Peterson. He was looking upfield before he caught the ball. That was apparent, and it'll bring up second and 10.
Adrian Peterson hasn't done much wrong this season. Screen pass right in his hands. He knows he should have caught that one. You see the first three possessions started out really good. Jarius Wright, it's been a field goal and a punt for the Minnesota Vikings.
Second down from the 14, and here's Peterson, finds running room. And Peterson gets the first down and is tackled to the 29 by Jacob Lacy, and a gain of 15. Here's the first by Adrian Peterson.
Well, he's the number one rusher in the NFL for a reason. He's special, and his offensive line's been special. Look at that hole. That's a big hole. But where Adrian Peterson, he give him any hole, he's going to make some damage happen. And the one thing watching this guy, Dick, he looks like he wants to score every time he touches the ball. That's not the case for most backs. We asked him about that. He said 100% accurate.
First down is fine. One more. And there is Ponder out of the pocket. First down. And Christian Ponder, hoping he wouldn't hear the boos from the crowd today, instead hearing cheers and well-deserved with a 20-yard run and a first down to the 49.
Well-deserved is right. We talked about him needing to stay in the pocket a little bit more, but when nothing's there, now it's time to get gone, and then you're going to get gone. Go make some yards, and Christian Ponder makes. Cliff Averill miss. Big yardage for Christian Ponder.
He has a touchdown rushing this year, averaging 4.4 yards per carry. From the Vikings 49, and the handoff is to Peterson, trying to break the tackle, gets back to the line of scrimmage, and let's check out now with Patrick O'Neill and a game break.
All right, Dick, thanks to the Superdome, where the Saints are home underdogs for the first time in a while. There's a reason for that. They're playing the lone undefeated team in the league, the Atlanta Falcons. Breeze, the Jimmy Graham, 29 yards. Atlanta had a 10-0 lead, but it's now 14-10. But Matt Ryan and the Falcons inside the 20 and threatening. Dick and John and Jennifer, back to you.
What a shootout. Thank you, Patrick. And Peterson again with another burst up the middle and another first down to the 37. He gets 14 more yards.
It's just beautiful to watch. Big holes for Adrian Peterson. But you give this guy anything, he's going to burst right through it. And you see the violence, the power, the vision, all of the things that make Adrian Peterson one of the great running backs ever to play this game.
Now he needs only 3 yards. First and 10 from the 37. And here is Ponder. And the catch made by Kyle Rudolph, the tight end. So now Adrian Peterson is over 1,000 for the fifth time in his career. And we talked about the amazing comeback from that ACL in the short period of time he's done.
He told us a couple weeks ago he's not interested in 1,000. He wants 2,000.
Yep.
He said, I'm greedy. I'll admit it, but that's what I want.
Sky's the limit for that man. Second down and 11 on the 38 of the Lions. Running the ball effectively. Ponder completing the pass to the tight end Kyle Rudolph. Rudolph had caught only 2 in the last 3 games, and he's looking to break out, and Silva makes the tackle.
And Dick, it's hard to figure how he could only have caught 2 in the last, because when you have Adrian Peterson, play action should be huge to your tight end. There it is. Where's that been? I don't know, but it's here today, and that's a good thing for the Minnesota Vikings.
16 yards for Rudolph. They consider him their version of Tony Gonzalez, the great tight end for Atlanta. From the 22, and there's the quick out to Jarius Wright. And Wright picking up about 7 or 8 yards. Lacy, former Colt, making the stop. And this has been a quick offense series for the Vikings.
It has, and you talk about quick. That young man right there, Jarius Wright,
They talk about him. They don't want to put him in Percy Harvin's class as of yet, but they say he's very similar to Percy in the things he does. That's a play they run to Percy all the time. Jarius Wright's stepping in very well for Percy Harvin thus far.
54-yard catch, setting up his own 3-yard catch for the only touchdown of the game thus far. Second down and 2, and here is Peterson. And Peterson may have enough for the first down. Averill was there to try to prevent that. Well, the Vikings, quick strike and Ponder's 20-yard run, helping a ground game against Jim Schwartz's Lions, who have been terrific against the run. They're going to measure to see whether Adrian Peterson has enough. First down for the Vikings, and without Harvin, they've spread it around, John.
Well, Dick, I mean, he's spreading around so much, he's even thrown it to himself. But we talked about sometimes when you have a guy like Percy Harvin that is so dynamic, you spend your whole day trying to get the ball to him. When he's not there, he can allow Christian Ponder just to work the offense, to run the offense, and he's doing it and doing it well today.
Kind of relaxing him, it looks like. First down at the 12 of the Lions. And here is Peterson, knocked back and will lose a couple of yards. DeAndre Levy returning to action at linebacker for Detroit this week, leading the charge.
Well, how do you stop a guy like Adrian Peterson? It's team defense, and it takes more than one guy. It takes all 11, and watch this, just watch it. People to the ball, they are where they're supposed to be, they're waiting for him, and then here comes the posse.
Second down and 13, 11th play of this drive. Ponder's pass, and it's dropped. Stephen Burton with an opportunity. And now third down and 13.
Stephen Burton in there because Percy Harvin's not here. You got to catch the football. You get your opportunities, you better make the most of them, or you are not going to get many more. Burton feels the heat with the Lions closing in. Big drop.
Toby Gerhardt seeing his first action in the backfield, lining up to the left of Ponder. Matthew Stafford ready to get back on the field. Third down and 13, and the pass is caught by Gerhardt, and the former Stanford player breaking a tackle is short of the first down but gets inside the 5-yard line. And it was Ricardo Silva who started for Louis Delmas today.
I tell you what, he's going to end up short, but what a tremendous effort by Toby Gerhardt. Looks like the Stanford guy, huh? Second effort all over the field.
You would know the Stanford players. And now the field goal team is coming on for the Vikings. So Gerhardt does his job with a 10-yard play, and now Blair Walsh will be on to try for him a chip shot. 23-yard field goal, it's perfect. And the Vikings extend their lead to 13-3. But they had two opportunities for a touchdown that went by the board, but they'll take a 10-point lead.
Today's game is sponsored by the Samsung Galaxy S3. The next big thing is already here.
Blair Walsh teeing it up with his second field goal of the game, an impressive 81-yard drive, and Ponder with a 20-yard run. And Peterson not too shabby himself in that run.
Talk about the best jobs in America. Maybe James Saxon has it, being Adrian Peterson's running back coach.
Here's the ball. You know what to do. And the Lions will take it out at the 20. So it's Veterans Day here in Minneapolis. And the Vikings have come out trying to end a 2-game losing streak and leading by 10. And we welcome you back to Ball of America Field. That's the Lion offense thus far today. Turnover cost them, resulting in a field goal for the Vikings. Dick Stockton along with John Lynch and Jennifer Hale.
Number 71.
Riley Reif reports as an extra offensive lineman. First down at the 20 for the Lions, who won the first meeting back in week four, I should say the Vikings did, in Detroit. There is LeSure trying to change direction. And he gets a couple.
Talk about the young rookie, Riley Reiff. He comes in as an extra tight end, but his impact on this team has been felt by both the Lions and their opposing teams. We talk about him being contagious, his type of play being contagious for the entire offensive line. They feel like they're playing better at the offensive line group than ever before, and they credit this rookie, which is a rare thing in this league.
He goes out, and Joy Bell, good receiver, lining up in the slot on second down and eight. Stafford going to the outside, and pass caught by Bell, and Bell close to the first down, covered by the rookie Josh Robinson. Lions have won three of the last four games in this series. Before that, the Vikings had dominated, winning 16 out of 17. And of course, said Detroit losing three out of four, then winning three out of four. And Minnesota, after the strong 4-1 start, have slumped. First down at the 30. Bell, with his first carry, gets some running room. He's a hard runner like LeSure, and Sanford knocks him back after a pickup of four.
This offense was set up this season to really have Jahvid Best, who's very explosive. They didn't have Jahvid Best. He hasn't been cleared from the concussion issues, was actually put on IR last week. But in Michael LeSure and Joik Bell, they've had two guys really step up into the role, and it's been big for this team. It's helped them dig out of that hole that they've been in.
Right now, the Lions are trying to dig out of the hole that they got them in starting this game. Second down and six. And a false start call against the Lions.
Number 66, offense. 5-yard penalty remains, second down.
It's the right guard, Steven Peterman.
You know, a big part of why you want to start fast if you're the Minnesota Vikings, you see Steven Peterman, that's why. Because the crowd can play fits on an opposing offensive line. I've done it as a player. I was in this division. We came here. More penalties in this stadium. It's like going to Seattle outdoors. It's loud. Offensive linemen hate it.
How did you handle it?
Not too well.
Little humble, Mr. Lynch. I think you handled it pretty well. Second down and 11. Play action. And the pass, trying to get it to Titus Young. And once again, good pressure put on, particularly by Jared Allen. Allen coming in leading the Vikings with 7.5 quarterback sacks. Well, the Lions have been outstanding on third downs in their two-game winning streak. Today, they've come up empty.
And the common theme's been third and long. They've been third and 11s, third and 9s, third and 7s. Not many plays in Scott Linehan's playbook for those situations.
Stafford needs 11 here. And a pass incomplete. Pettigrew was covered well by Jasper Brinkley. So the Vikings defense holds, and Nick Harris will come on to kick for Detroit. 2:35 remaining in the half.
And watch this right here. This is how you take care of a guy like Calvin Johnson. You get your hands on him at the line of scrimmage. It disrupts the rhythm of the play. He's a long strider. If you can break it up, it serves you well as a defense. Nice job by the Vikings.
Harris's kick and the fair catch by Sherrills as he goes out of bounds at the 28. Johnson, by the way, with three catches in the game. Well, this Tuesday, don't miss a night of all-new comedy right here on Fox with Raising Hope, Ben and Kate, New Girl, and the Mindy Project. It's a night so funny, the TV guy suggests you simply surrender and enjoy. So laugh your box off starting at 8, 7 Central, Tuesday on Fox. Vikings losing three of their last four. Their one win was against Arizona back on October 21st. First down at the 29. Ponder to throw on first down, gets some pressure, and incomplete. Coming up the middle was Dominican Sue. First time we've mentioned his name today.
Seeing Dominican Sue, a lot was made about the fact that he didn't have a tackle last week. He played well. And that kind of effort is what makes this guy a special player. I was talking to some of the Detroit coaches, and they put on film this week from last year, illustrating the same point. We're playing good as a D-line. We got more in us. And one of the games they showed him was against Minnesota when they wreaked havoc on Christian Ponder.
That was the first game in his career he didn't make a tackle. This pass will be caught and spun out of bounds. Michael Jenkins, the former Falcon, and Chris Houston, who's having a terrific year, limits Jenkins to a four-yard gain. He did not get out of bounds, so we're approaching the two-minute warning, trying to get another playoff. The Vikings do. Ponder gets it away, and a terrific catch is made by Adrian Peterson, avoiding the loss. And the two-minute warning will come, so good play by Ponder and Peterson as Sue very nearly got Ponder for the sack. Two-minute warning. We'll be back.
Dick, we go back to that last third and seven. I think terrible clock management by the Minnesota Vikings and Christian Ponder. You're rushing before the two-minute warning to get a play in. You've got three timeouts. It's not an issue. Now you give the ball back to Detroit and Matthew Stafford with a lot of time left and two timeouts themselves. Leslie Frazier knew it right there. Bad clock management.
Let's see if it comes back to bite the Vikings. Logan backpedaling after the good punt. Will run it from the 10-yard line. And Stephon Logan, who has been one of the outstanding returners in the past. 57-yard punt that time by Cluey. And so Stafford with two timeouts remaining. And 1:44 on the clock.
You really have to credit this Minnesota defense. They've been doing a really nice job of keeping Matthew Stafford off rhythm, off stopping the run game, keeping this Detroit offense that's very explosive to only 3 points.
Now, Joyce Bell is in the backfield, and this pass will be caught on the outside by Calvin Johnson, who's covered immediately by Josh Robinson. It's been his assignment in this first half, and a gain of only two.
That's good football. We talked about it in the simplify the game portion. He's going to get his catches, but limited. He can't go over the top of you. Catch it in front and go up and make the tackle. Second and eight, you'll take that all day long, particularly with Calvin Johnson catching the ball.
Johnson's longest catch, John, 23 yards, averaging just 9 yards a catch. Vikings will take that all day.
And twice on Sunday.
So let's do it today. Second down and eight. Stafford's pass and nearly intercepted. Goes through the arms of Tony Scheffler, and it was... I don't think it touched anyone, and the Vikings go in, and it's a touchdown. And it's Antoine Winfield. Talk about delayed action, Antoine Winfield. Everyone stopped when the ball went through Scheffler's hands, and it bounced off of the knee of Jefferson, I believe. Yes, deflects into the hands of Winfield.
Look at Winfield. He stops. He's about to give the ball back to the official. Off the ground, off his knee. Off the ground, now into Winfield's hands.
We will review the previous play.
Pinball machine time, John, and it hit the ground. But the Vikings kept playing.
Yeah, the coaches used to say, you never know unless you go. So go to the end zone and let them figure out later. Good job by Antoine Winfield.
The official signaled a touchdown. This happened fast.
You know, Dick, and I really think a good job by the officials. This is going to come back. It's going to be overturned. But if you don't allow it, you can't go back and have the touchdown. So now they can go back and fix it. The other way, you couldn't.
It's a booth review, and while they take a look, Jim Schwartz knows it hit the ground. We'll come back officially in just a moment. Well, we're in the midst of a booth review on a... here's Pete Morelli.
After reviewing the play, the pass hit the ground, and it is an incomplete pass. Please set the game clock to 1:36, and it'll be third down.
Antoine Winfield had a big smile on his face as we saw, John. He knew.
You talk about rose-colored glasses. The Vikings fan booed that call, but clear as day, off the knee, off the turf. And good try by Antoine Winfield. You can't blame a brother for trying.
So... Third down and 8. Lions on the 28, trying to get something before intermission. They still have 2 timeouts remaining. The Vikings get a stop here. They'll have 3 timeouts themselves with enough time. Stafford goes down. He saw Everson Griffin coming. And the second time the Vikings have gotten to Stafford. And that'll bring up 4th down with a 10-yard loss.
Everson Griffin likes playing against the Detroit Lions. Had 2 sacks in their week 4 win. And he's active here today as well.
Well, after really kind of messing up the game clock on that last possession, the Vikings will get another chance. They have 2 timeouts remaining with 1:30 to go in the half and starting from the 18.
Really credit this defense. They've been outstanding stopping this potent Detroit Lions offense, keeping them to 3 points. Good stuff by the Minnesota defense.
So Sherrills will return the punt by Harris. His 77-yard return was against these Lions in week 4. So Harris will punt from inside the 5. Again, 2 timeouts left for the Vikings. Sherrills makes the catch at the 42. Well, halftime is coming up, and for an idea of what we have in store on the Visa Halftime Report, let's check in with Kurt Menefee.
Coming up on the Visa Halftime, we'll have highlights from a busy Week 10, including Peyton Manning taking on Cam Newton, Jake Locker returning to the Titans as they meet Miami, and Tom Brady and the Patriots hosting the Bills. So we'll power up, get TV, and have everything for you at the Visa Halftime.
Two timeouts remaining for the Vikings, 2 for the Lions. Ponder on first down. And the catch caught by Simpson, a couple of yards shy of the first down.
Would be just huge. One thing good teams do, the Atlanta Falcons talk about it all the time, is score before the half. Get points on the board. It'd be critical for the Minnesota Vikings.
Quick toss. And the pass incomplete. Jenkins, the intended receiver, so it'll be 3rd down and 1. Percy Harvin with a sprained ankle was on crutches this week, unable to play. And the Vikings so far leading by a 13-3 score. Third down and 1 on the Lions 49. Here is Peterson, and he's knocked back. A good play by Stephen Tulloch. Terrific play. Knocks Peterson back for a loss of 2. And now the Lions will call a timeout. They have 1 left.
Watch Stephen Tulloch. This is playing downhill football. And getting there on Adrian Peterson's 1 thing, bringing him down to another thing. Stephen Tulloch, in the first game that these guys met on a 3rd and 1, was in the backfield. Here we are, week 4, 3rd and 1. Great reaction by Stephen Tulloch. What's he come up with? A shoe. Stephen Tulloch says, one of my better reads of the year, and that's Adrian Peterson. He's a machine. I came up with a shoe. Not this time. He stops Adrian Peterson on 3rd and 1.
Well, Peterson has been stopped for losses on 3 plays. He has 37 yards on 11 carries. His longest run was 15. So Chris Cluey will be punting to Stevon Logan. 57 seconds remaining in the first half. And the Lions with 1 timeout remaining. And Logan is going to let this one fly into the end zone. So that's how much time remains for the Lions to at least get in position for a field goal. 51-yard kick that time by Cluey. Those are Stafford's numbers. He's thrown 1 interception to Greenway. LeSure, 26 yards, and Johnson with 4 catches for 36. Nothing really that jumps out of you with what the Lions have done offensively.
I think it's more so the job that the Minnesota Vikings have done defensively. Plenty of time here, though, to drive the football. And Matthew Stafford's got the type of arm that can get the ball downfield in a hurry.
A.J. Jefferson defending against Calvin Johnson below, and the pass out of the backfield to Joint Bell. And Bell stays on the field to play. Clock continues to run. Greenway and Jefferson combine.
Lions seem content to go into the half with a 13-3 deficit. I'm surprised they didn't try to push it. Joe Bell should have got out of bounds there.
Stafford, and out of the backfield, Bell again. And a good tackle saving the first down is Winfield, although the first down is not the big issue here. And the clock running. And the final seconds, Lions are going to accept the deficit of 10 points. That'll do it for the first half. And the Minnesota Vikings defense holding the Lions to only 3 points. And the Vikings looking to end their two-game losing streak and go to 6-4 on the season.
Said they needed a great start. They got that great start. Now the question is, can they hang on? Remember, the Detroit Lions, nobody better at closing than the Detroit Lions offensively, lead the league in fourth quarter scoring.
So the halftime lead by the Minnesota Vikings, 13-3 over the Lions, and we'll be right back after these messages. Here on Veterans Day, the Lions and the Vikings getting set for the start of the second half. Follow your favorite team all season long. Go to iTunes.com/NFL. The Vikings lead the Lions by a score of 13-3. And, John, you wonder whether this is a tenuous 10-point lead for Minnesota.
Well, I think it could be described as that, certainly. And I think if I'm Leslie Frazier, I tell my team, we got to keep our foot on the gas. We can't cruise home because this team on the other side, the Detroit Lions, they're the best closers in football. Three games that they've won in with fourth quarter deficits this year. They score more points than any team in the NFL. The Vikings cannot cruise. They got to stay in attack mode.
And at the same time, the Lions can't afford to see that margin so big that even a fourth quarter rally won't get it done. But the Vikings will get the ball first. They won the toss and deferred. And so they will get the ball now. And Marcus Sherrills is back deep for the second half kickoff. The only touchdown happened early. Darius Wright on a 3-yard catch from Ponder, and it's Sherrills running it out. And Sherrills trying to get some running room from the outside, breaks one past the 30-yard line, and Sherrills with a big start to the second half of the Vikings. Jason Hansen, the kicker, knocked him out of bounds after a 41-yard return as we check in with the third member of our team once again, Jennifer Hale.
Well, Dick, the Vikings are keeping their quarterbacks coach Craig Johnson down on the field this game versus where it usually is up in the booth, just to give Christian Ponder an extra set of eyes, a little boost of confidence. Speaking of which, Leslie Frazier tells me that opening touchdown was key for the Vikings to boost Ponder's confidence in himself. Meanwhile, the Lions, their confidence is not shaken. Jim Schwartz tells me, hey, we've been here before down on the road. We are the leading scorer in the NFL in the fourth quarter. We just need to establish our run game and force them to respect it in the second half, Dick.
All right, Jennifer, but first the Lions defense has to short-circuit the Vikings as Kyle Rudolph makes the catch for a 4-yard pickup. Taking a look at the first half numbers, and third downs were not kind to either team.
To either team, good defense, not executing on offense. Both teams will have to change that to be successful.
Second down and 6, and here's Adrian Peterson, jumps to the outside, and Peterson gets the first down. And a flag is down as well, and a Lion player is injured back at the 40-yard line as Peterson picks up 8 yards, and Cliff Averill, the defensive end, slow getting up, and now the
holding, number 81, the offense, 10-yard penalty, still second down.
So Jerome Simpson, the wide receiver, holding.
And you see Jerome Simpson out here on the left side of the offensive formation, and he's going to get a handful. And it's, you know, at times you love to see your receivers battling, but you don't need to. You got Adrian Peterson. The guy's not close to him. Let him go. A critical mistake by Jerome Simpson.
And Willie Young replaces Cliff Averill up front for the Lions.
Averill had missed practice time this week with an ailing back.
Second down and 12. Jarius Wright is in the game right now, and there's a catch made by Jerome Simpson. And trying to knock the ball out was Justin Durant, but a gain of 18 yards to Simpson, former Bengal.
My old coach for the Denver Broncos, Mike Shanahan, said at wide receiver, you either win the one-on-one battles or you're going to be selling cars. And the point was, you better win one-on-one battles. Jerome Simpson, the Minnesota Vikings receivers haven't been the last couple of weeks. They're doing it today. It's paying off in first downs.
He's been bothered by leg and back injuries, not quite up to the level earlier of the year, but they need him today without Harmon. Here's Adrian Peterson, and Peterson will get about 2.5 yards as the Vikings working their way into Lion territory. That was a 3-yard gain. And the ball at the 44 of Detroit. Ponder, 15 for 20, 123 yards and a touchdown. He also rushed for 20. Peterson, they kind of held him relatively in check for who he is. And Wright, spectacular in his NFL debut.
I'll tell you, if I'm the Vikings, I keep Craig Johnson down on the field, because if that's what's making Christian Ponder play like this, stay with it.
Ponder. And this pass off the hands of Kyle Rudolph, and Ponder gets knocked down. Did a good job of getting rid of that.
I like some of the subtle things that he's doing today. We talked earlier in the game on him not staying in the pocket. Today he's staying in the pocket. You see the Lions bring the pressure, get to him, but they don't get him down. Ponder hanging in there. Rudolph comes right off his hands.
Third and 7 at the Lion 43. Toby Gerhardt going out as a pass receiver. Flag is down, and Rudolph makes the catch. And it'll be a first down pending the call inside the 30. But let's see if this comes back.
Illegal formation. Number 71 offense. 5-yard penalty. Remains third down.
So the right tackle, Phil Loadholt, and that is a key penalty. Would have been a first down inside the 30. Instead, they'll move the ball back.
And you see Phil Loadholt a little off the line of scrimmage. Sometimes tackles try to buy themselves a little time by backing up. I'm not so sure he wasn't on sides right there. Judgment called by the referee, the linesman, and he called.
So now third down and 12. Back at the 48 of Detroit. Here comes the blitz. Picked up well. Ponder. And Ponder gets to the 41. Durant prevents any further gain. Pickup of 7 yards, and that'll be fourth down. And Cluey will come in as the Vikings will punt.
Good job by the Detroit Lions defense. That's another thing that I think the Vikings, you talk about all the elements of their pass game that have been struggling. You've got a quarterback that can move a little. Well, when he does move, you better uncover. There's rules. The guys deep, they come back. The guys shallow, they go deep. The intermediate guys go to the sideline. Coaches work on this. They haven't, and it showed up in the game.
And John, the illegal formation call on Loadholt really hurt the Vikings, who would have been inside the Lions 30. And this punt is going to be down and picked up. Question is, was it touched by a Viking? In any event, the Lions will start from the 7-yard line. Good coverage by Alfonso Smith. So the Lions offense, how prolific are they? We'll find out when they come on the field.
Today's game on Fox is sponsored by Southwest Airlines. Find our fares online only at southwest.com. By Miller Lite, it's not just a good time, it's Miller time. By Nissan, innovation that excites. And by Chili's.
The Walker Art Center here in Minneapolis, first down at the 7. Here's LeSure. And LeSure may have gotten back to the line of scrimmage thanks to Jared Allen. As the Lions, who earlier started from the 8, now from the 7.
See Jared Allen right here, tremendous player, and he always plays well against the Detroit Lions. There's that relentless effort that we've come to know Jared Allen by. The Vikings have been living in the Detroit Lions backfield, and Jared Allen, he does that better than anybody in this league.
Well, when the Lions started from the 8 in the first half, they ended up driving for a field goal. They have a second down and 10 from the 7. And the pass incomplete. And it's Brandon Pettigrew, the tight end, and it looked like he had a chance to catch this one. And drop balls have been plaguing the Lions all season long.
And the drop ball now sets up a situation that was real familiar in the first half. Third and 10 shows up with the 0-for-6 efficiency for the Detroit Lions. And Jared Allen got Jeff Backus. He rides Jeff Backus right into Matthew Stafford's lap.
Looks like a new gear for Allen. Third and 10 from the end zone is Stafford. And Stafford gets to the 10, does not go out of bounds. Griffin makes the tackle, and the Vikings, with a superb defensive sequence there, will force Nick Harris to kick from the end zone.
You watch Josh Robinson, another coverage sack. Get good hands on him early. There's no separation right there. Matthew Stafford then gets flushed from the pocket. Really good defense by the Minnesota Vikings.
Harris with a high kick and a fair catch called for by Sherrills in Lions territory. And the Vikings will be at the 47 of Detroit. Allen playing a big role defensively, and Matthew Stafford has seen better moments. Starting from the 48 of the Lions, you like what the Vikings have done offensively?
I do. I think they've been balanced. You need balance in this league. And for them, that means being able to throw the football. Christian Ponder's done it well today.
What sets it up is the run to Peterson, who had 1,000 yards and then went back with some losses and now over the 1,000 mark again. Picks up 3 yards here.
And what's so incredible about Adrian Peterson is he does it against the odds, meaning they've got 8 in the box. Right there, they go heavy personnel, 2 tight ends, 2 backs. You've now got 9 in the box, and he still is so productive.
He needed 43 to get to 1,000 for the 5th time in his career. And again, it's Peterson. Peterson, with a little hurdle, works his way to the 41 of the Lions, bringing up 3rd and short. 4 yards there.
3rd and short is the key word. When you get in situations like this in 3rd down, it really opens up the playbook of offensive coordinator Bill Musgrave. Now we can do the things we talked about, spreading the football around. Is it Rudolph? Is it Jarius Wright? Is it Gerhardt out of the backfield? A lot of options in a 3rd and 4th situation.
Well, Gerhardt is in the backfield now on 3rd down and 3. Ponder gets a rush. Pass is caught for the first down by Kyle Rudolph, who wouldn't budge. DeAndre Levy tried to knock him back so they wouldn't get the first down, but Rudolph held his ground, and it is a first down at the 37.
And Dick, you said earlier, this is their version of Tony Gonzalez. Not so fast. He might be someday. That's what he aspires to be, but this looks a whole lot like Tony Gonzalez. Using the body, extending the arms, that's the type of football Kyle Rudolph needs to start playing.
So Rudolph with 5 catches today. And a first down at the 37 of Detroit. And an end around. Jarius Wright shakes off one defender and nearly another one. And ends up with 3 yards after all of that as Lacey and Silva from the Lions secondary caught up with it.
And really give a lot of credit to Kyle VandenBosch on this play. He doesn't make the tackle, but he slows Jarius Wright down. Otherwise, this is a big game. And it's really, you see VandenBosch right here on his job. He slows him down enough that it doesn't turn into a big gainer. Good job by Jarius Wright, though, getting yards with VandenBosch in his backfield.
Second down and 7. Play action. Ponder drills it, and it's caught by Aroma Shadu. Devin Aroma Shadu down inside the 5. And they've been saving the former Chicago Bear for a play like that. 32 yards, and it'll be first and goal, Minnesota.
And give this one to Adrian Peterson, because all the attention comes to him when you're the number one rusher in the league.
Devin Aroma should do, just give him a little window. Good ball by Christian Ponder. He's throwing the ball with authority, and his head coach really likes it. You see Leslie Frazier, that's about as much excitement as you see from Leslie Frazier, but that's really exciting.
They told us that inside he's a lot more fiery than he lets on.
He's a lot like my old coach Tony Dungy in that way.
First and goal from the three, and Ponder, and you got to say, why to get rid of it? Take your loss. You're in good shape there. And it'll be second and goal.
Watch Christian Ponder. It's the foot of the right guard, Fusco, that catches his foot as he's coming out. And Pete Morelli whistles it dead before he can throw the incompletion. So a lost yardage.
Up 7 yards, second and goal. Vikings had first and goal at the three. Now they're at the 10. Ponder. And Ponder has Adrian Peterson, who's tackled by Eric Coleman. Coleman playing today, starting for Spivey, shaken up earlier, came back, and there'll be a loss of one. So now it's third and goal. Ponder has thrown to 9 different receivers, underscoring the point that my partner John Lynch made at the top of the game. You don't have Harbin, and maybe for Ponder it's good that you're going to run the offense with a lot of different receivers.
Yeah, that was all right for the first half. I sure love to have Percy Harbin right about now.
Third down and goal on the 10. And they go underneath to Gerhardt, and Gerhardt will be tackled at the 5 by Lacy. And the crowd not happy with the Vikings there. They have first and goal at the 3, and now are forced to settle for a field goal. And not quite getting the score that would kind of giving them good breathing room.
You know, and the fans are upset. They're always going to be upset when they throw the checkdowns. But at some point, you give credit to the Detroit Lions. I'm watching. Nothing was open downfield right there. He did the smart thing, gave it to Gerhardt, and it sets up the field goal.
23-yarder by Blair Walsh. He's 3 for 3 today. So after that early touchdown, it's been a field goal show by both teams. 16-3, the Vikings. Vikings leading 16-3. That was a 9-play drive. Ponder was perfect, but they had first and goal at the 3, and as John mentioned, the Lions defense stiffened. Stephon Logan is back. And it's returned from the goal line by Logan. And Logan is tackled just before he gets to the 20. Well, the Minnesota Vikings have had good reason to dance. They've allowed only a field goal to the Lions with 5 to go in the third.
The family they play.
First down from the 19 for the Lions, Matthew Stafford. They fake an end around, and the pass is caught by Calvin Johnson. And Johnson with a first down out to the 39, picking up nearly 20.
And that's more of what the Detroit Lions need to start doing, is find a way to get it to Calvin Johnson.
Number 71 has reported.
When you run the football, they aren't running it as effectively as they have. To give credit to the Minnesota Vikings. But that's going to open up. If you keep doing it, it's going to open up Calvin Johnson. That's your best player. Feed him when you need him.
He's caught 5. Going in the air again. Stafford has plenty of time. And taking a shot downfield. And the catch is made by Calvin Johnson. When you can do it, take the shot to him. John, you just said it, and they did. Shaken up for the moment. Smith and Sanford defending. A 51-yard play puts the Lions in business.
And it's just what you do. You throw the football, give the football to your best players when the game's at the critical moments. And that, you'll take that matchup all day long. You get Calvin Johnson on Jamarcus Sanford. Jamarcus Sanford's a really good football player, but you got Calvin Johnson right there. 6'5", can jump. He's going to go get the football. Great play call by Linehan. Great execution by Stafford and Calvin Johnson.
And that's the matches the longest throw to Johnson this year, 51 yards. And there is Stafford, who covers up immediately instead of seeing at the turnover, and will take the loss of 5 yards here. And it'll be second down. So Calvin Johnson, who's been bothered by sore knees, didn't practice until Friday.
Stafford clearly not ready for that ball from Raiola. He does a nice job of just covering it up. And here's where the Lions got to get back to their recent trend. Inside the red zone, score touchdowns.
They were 8 for 8, and then they fizzled in this game. Second down and 15 at the 16. And this pass will be caught by Brandon Pettigrew for the touchdown. So the Lions, and a salute from Pettigrew on Veterans Day, finally score their first touchdown of the game, a 16-yard pass from Stafford to the tight end.
Well, Harrison Smith, the rookie safety for the Minnesota Vikings, in coverage on Pettigrew, and he's a fine player. Pettigrew gets the best of this one, though. He catches Harrison Smith off balance, gives a little push, perfectly thrown football by Matthew Stafford. The explosive offense from the Detroit offense has woken up.
Second touchdown catch by Pettigrew this year, and Jason Hansen with the extra point. So the Viking lead is now 6, and we know that they've had opportunities to get touchdowns. They've had to settle for field goals. They had the 10-point lead at the half, and now the Lions have made it uncomfortable for the Minnesota Vikings and for Al Williams. Little frustration there. 6-point game. And Brandon Pettigrew with the touchdown catch. 4 plays, 81 yards, but Calvin Johnson, the featured receiver, he caught a pair for 70 yards, including one for 51. Lions back in business.
That's why you got to keep your foot on the gas if you're the Minnesota Vikings. As I said, you're not going to cruise to victory against the Detroit Lions. They're too explosive. We'll see what Christian Ponder and this Vikings offense can do.
Hansen kicking to Sherrills. And a fumble. Loose ball. Ball came loose on the return. And Aaron, well, one of the Lions, come out, and it's recovered by Minnesota.
Christian Ballard catches the ball. I played for Bill Walsh in college, and before every game he would say, if you're a defensive player not used to carrying the ball, you get it, take a knee, because you're not used to carrying it. Christian Ballard certainly not used to carrying it, but if you're going to fumble it, recover it yourself, and Christian Ballard does just that.
Travis Lewis had an opportunity. He came out of it without his helmet, so the Vikings will have a first down. And we'll start from the 37, Jim Schwartz's Lions, who trying to make it 3 in a row and 4 out of 5. Now down by 6. Ponder to throw on first down, going underneath to Peterson, and Peterson to the 44-yard line, picking up 6 yards. I want to remind you, last year here the Vikings led the Lions 20-0 at the half. That was early in the season, and the Lions ended up winning the game 26-23. Of course, we've chronicled how the Lions do their best scoring in the latter stages. Second down and 4. Again, looking to throw, and this pass caught by John Carlson, and he gets a first down into Lion territory to the 46. Carlson active today after missing a couple of games with a concussion.
Here's John Carlson. He's going to come across the formation after the fake to Peterson. This is a guy that they really plan their offense around, the two tight end looks. Really credit Bill Musgrave for moving the football around without the services of Percy Harvin, doing a tremendous job calling the game for Christian Ponder. He's doing a nice job of executing.
11 yards there. And here's Peterson. Peterson lost his footing. No gain.
Detroit really doing a nice job of bottling up Adrian Peterson. He's out 3 yards per carry right now. And it's about guys being in their gaps. And then once you're there, you see Gunther Cunningham, the defensive coordinator. It's about finishing. And that's easier said than done with Adrian Peterson.
His longest game, John, is 15 yards. And Jim Schwartz said the longest gain he had in the first game was only 18. So they kept him under wraps pretty well. Second down and 10. Ponder's throw, and it is caught inside the 40 by Michael Jenkins. Short of the first down by two. Let's check in with Kurt Menefee in a game break.
Well, the Giants have turned it over three straight possessions here in the third quarter. The latest turned into an Andy Dalton, Mohamed Sanu touchdown. And right now, the Bengals are pouring it on. 31-6. 4.5 minutes to go in the third quarter. They roll past the Giants right now. Dick and John?
Haven't we seen the Giants in a November slumber?
Come on, Michael. What's going on?
Second down. Or third down, that is, as Ponder's throw is caught. And that'll be a first down to the 25. Kyle Rudolph with a good catch that time. Picks up 13 yards. So the Vikings answering the Lions score. Right now they're impressive, and that should do it for the third.
Well, Rudolph needed to emerge, and he has today. Christian Ponder getting it to him, and that's what's big tight ends with those huge radiuses are supposed to do. You throw the ball, you may have people on you, but make the catch.
And that'll do it. That'll be the end of the third quarter with the score. The Vikings 16 and the Lions 10. And Fox NFL Sunday will continue after a break from your local Fox station. Start of the fourth quarter here in Minneapolis. First and 10 for the Vikings. Ponder trying to get it to Jerome Simpson, incomplete. Ponder in the third quarter completed 10 of 11 for 99 yards. And with Harvin out, something you pointed out earlier, 10 different receivers for Minnesota. There is the score by quarters, keeping in mind the Lions have done the lion's share of their point making in the fourth.
Down. Ready.
Second down and 10, all at the 24. Here's Peterson for the first. Peterson working his way close to the 20. Coleman, the strong safety, was there. He got four.
Really a good tackle by Coleman. That looks easy, hard to do. I've been there many times. You're going against a great back like Adrian Peterson. All right, you're in position. Now go ahead and make the tackle. Eric Coleman does it well.
Third down and 6. Since that first touchdown, the Vikings have had to settle for field goals. Here's Ponder, and the pass is caught. First down to Kyle Rudolph, and Rudolph will walk in for the touchdown. Gotta wonder about the Lions tackling downfield to Rudolph.
This was a game where Kyle Rudolph was going to have to emerge. Percy Harvin out, someone's got to step up. Kyle Rudolph has done exactly that. He gets a little hand from his buddy Michael Jenkins at the end of the play with a good block. Might have been a hold, but they didn't catch it, so Kyle Rudolph, touchdown.
So he caught two passes in the last three games, John. He has seven today. A 20-yard touchdown catch right there, and now the Vikings will go for two, leading by 12. Early here in the fourth, and the Lions will call their first timeout. Take a timeout. Very impressive Viking drive answering the Lions touchdown.
Today's game on Fox is sponsored by Microsoft Surface. By Bud Light, the official beer of NFL fans. Here we go. And by Burger King and the delicious new holiday sweets.
And back here in Minneapolis, Leslie Frazier doesn't want to look, but he will. 62-yard drive, and now the Vikings, after the Lion timeout, going for two to give them a 14-point lead. And here's Adrian Peterson, barrels in straight ahead for the two-point conversion. What better guy to give it to than AP?
You see in the last two drives, the Lions went to their best player, Calvin Johnson.
the Minnesota Vikings give it to their best player, Adrian Peterson.
It's okay to look danger.
He's a happy man.
That's the Vikings scoring drive, and Ponder 2 for 2 on third down, both to Rudolph, whose 20-yard TD catch, giving them a 24-10 lead, 8 for 9 for 113 yards and a touchdown. Four of them for first downs on third downs in this game. Ponder has come back strong to this point. Logan will keep it in the end zone for a touchback, and the Lions will start at the 20. Well, this week, Fox College Saturday begins with a Pac-12 showdown between crosstown rivals as the 19th-ranked USC Trojans take on the 18th-rated UCLA Bruins. Then the 12th-ranked Oklahoma Sooners square off against the West Virginia Mountaineers. Coverage of Fox College football begins Saturday at 2:30 Eastern, 11:30 Pacific. You always have to be wary of the Lions in the fourth quarter, but at least the Vikings with their biggest lead now, 24-10. And here's LeSueur cutting to the outside, gets to the 23, where Winfield makes his 8th tackle of the game and a gain of 3.
And Antoine Winfield, one of the better tackling corners in this game. He does it so well, and he's going to have to do it. There you see the prowess of the Detroit Lions in the fourth quarter. They are explosive. We saw it in the last drive. If I'm the Minnesota Vikings, I am getting hands on Calvin Johnson. My old teammate Champ Bailey said, you get them early or they'll get you late. Get him early at the line of scrimmage.
Second down and 7. Fake a handoff. Backing up, and the pass out of the backfield to LeSueur. And LeSueur, and a flag is thrown. LeSueur is tackled a yard shy of the first down, and a penalty marker emphatically thrown from the sideline.
Be a late hit on Mistrail Raymond, just a foolish hit. Undisciplined football.
After the play was over, personal foul. Number 41, defense. Unnecessary roughness, late hit. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Raymond was out the last 6 games with a dislocated ankle. Did not start today. Sanford did.
You see LeSueur clearly down, and then Raymond comes in and finishes him off. Unnecessary, unneeded, and it hurts his team right here.
Now the Lions have the ball on their 43 after the 6-yard gain, tacking on 15 more. And here is LeSueur, gets running room up the middle, and LeSueur with a first down and into Viking territory to the 43. And it was Riley Reed. He's been in there today with a terrific block.
Watch Alan Williams, the safety. Harrison Smith comes up. Good call by Alan Williams. He puts Harrison Smith in position to make the play. You got to finish the play. He's done a great job in his rookie season, but you have to tackle at the safety position. His coach had him in position. You got to make the play.
14 yards there. First and 10 at the 43 of the Vikings. Plenty of time. Stafford was looking deep. Now he's just looking, and he completes it to Calvin Johnson inside the 30-yard line. And another first down, so 15 more, and this is the Lion fourth quarter offense. They've been fierce this way.
I mentioned earlier, our underrated part of Matthew Stafford's game is his athleticism. Look at him run to extend the play and then keep his eyes downfield. Calvin Johnson does a great job of coming back to his quarterback, finding the open zone, and Stafford delivers a strike. Good football by the Detroit Lions.
And he had a tough play going to his left.
Yes.
And throwing. Joy Bell is in the game. They fake a handoff to him, and this pass is caught by Calvin Johnson, and a flag is down. Johnson makes the catch inside the 5, and a penalty. Johnson with 121 yards now receiving.
You see Calvin Johnson in the slot. Sometimes they're doubled, sometimes they're tripled. That's faith in your receiver that he's going to make the catch. I believe they're going to call helmet to helmet, but I'm not sure. Well,
personal foul, unnecessary roughness, number 54, defense, contact with him.
Brinkley.
It's a good call. Good call. His helmet does hit Calvin Johnson right in the face mask. 10 years ago, probably not a flag. Today, it's a flag.
So now Calvin Johnson with 146 yards. Receiving, and a first and goal for the Lions. And the slant and the pass, touchdown to Titus Young. So the Lions scored a touchdown, and the Vikings answered that with a score and a two-point conversion. Detroit goes down the field quickly.
Winning the one-on-one battles. The Detroit Lions starting to do it at the wide receiver position. Calvin Johnson winning the one-against-three battles. These receivers are starting to come to life. Matthew Stafford is lethal when these guys play like this.
Fourth touchdown catch by Young. Jason Hansen on for the extra point. And it's now 24-17, and John, all I think the Lions need to do is look up and say, hey, it's the fourth quarter.
And all Christian Ponder needs to do is say, hey, it's the fourth quarter, we better keep scoring.
24-17 on a six-play, 82-yard drive. What really is impressive is it took us to get the touchdown.
The last two drives have been quick, have been explosive, and that's what this offense is. You got Calvin Johnson. We've been talking about them running the football. Well, when you do that enough, it opens up Calvin Johnson. And then sometimes as a quarterback, I don't care how many guys they got on him, we're throwing it to him.
So Calvin Johnson, and coming into this game, had four straight 100-yard games. And now has number five with 146 yards on eight catches.
I thought the most impressive one was the one at the Jaguars last week. Hadn't practiced all week. Was a game-time decision. I'm watching the film. He's limping all over. How'd you like to come up with 129 yards on a bad wheel?
And that is what he's done today. And it's almost as the world turns, the soap opera. Practice Friday with the sore knee. Said this week that he suffered a stinger, not a concussion. And it was against the Vikings, and he said, use the term nerve damage. He recanted that, recanted concussion. Hard to keep up with him. Today, the Vikings are having trouble keeping up with him.
Yes, sir.
And how about this star? Marcus Sherrills is in the field of play, 2 yards, returning this one for the Vikings. And gets to the 22. And let's check in now with Kurt Menefee with a game break. Kurt.
You guys were talking Calvin Johnson. Another big receiving day for Tony Gonzalez. This is second touchdown. 101 in his career. Sixth place on the all-time list. First tight end ever with triple digits. More importantly, it pulls Atlanta to within four at New Orleans. A long way to go. 12 and a half left in the fourth as the Falcons try to remain perfect, Dick.
What an entertaining shootout that is.
Absolutely. Two explosive offenses down there. Not a whole lot of defense being played.
Let's see how the Vikings answer that last score by the Lions. They did pretty well the first time around. Leading now by seven, first down. And Adrian Peterson brings it out to the 25. I said that was a last and a quick score by the Lions. 43 seconds. It was really 2 minutes and 43 seconds.
I want you to look at this. The numbers in there. That's nine people that they're running against. You aren't supposed to be able to run against this. But Adrian Peterson, he's going to find the hole. He's going to find the yards. He's going to churn his legs. All of a sudden, you get 4 yards. That's a positive first down.
59 yards on 18 carries. This is his 19th carry of the game. And sees the sticks, short of it by about three.
What effort, though. Coaches talk a lot. When your best players show the greatest effort, what a representation for the rest of your team. Can you imagine being on the Vikings? You're going to play hard because you know your best player is playing hard every play. This guy's one of a kind. We're watching greatness in our presence right now.
Came in as the leading rusher in the league. It'll be third down and two. On the Viking 29. Ponder will throw it. And Rudolph says he was held by DeAndre Levy. No flag is down. Crowd disapproving of that no call. It's fourth down. And Chris Cluey will come in to punt.
Winning the one-on-one, so critical. You know, I'm not going to sit here and armchair quarterback this, but I'm telling you, on the Detroit Lions right now, you're seeing them feed their best player, Calvin Johnson. Third and two. I might hand it to 28.
Stephon Logan standing at the 25. Here's his return. Logan to the 40. And Logan. And the Lions are yelling that there should be a horse collar, I think, on that play. Horse collar tackle. No flag is thrown there. 27-yard return after the 55-yard kick. Cluey makes the tackle.
Today's game is sponsored by Chevrolet. From kickoff to the last yard, Chevy runs deep.
Best starting field position of the day for the Lions. The 48 in the pitch going out to Michael LeSueur. And LeSueur, flag is down, and LeSueur is out of bounds at the 47. How about Calvin Johnson? They said, you're the guy we're going to in the second half. In the half.
Number 76 offense. 10-yard penalty. Remains first down.
Meanwhile, Jeff Backus is called for holding.
Going to toss it out to the left side, and Backus is going to lead it. Chad Greenway goes to get the play, and when you're as active as Chad Greenway and his athletic offensive linemen tend to panic, Backus does. He holds him. Detroit going backwards.
They were in Viking territory. Now they're back on their own 38. Stafford swings it out to LeSueur, who can't hold on. And that'll bring up second down and 20. Once again, the defense of Calvin Johnson in his hand.
And you see in the first half, hands on Calvin Johnson early. They're up in his face. They're bumping him. They're breaking his stride. He's getting frustrated. You see in the second half, three releases. Don't do it, first Calvin Johnson. I said it earlier. You get them early, or he'll get you late. Calvin Johnson's getting them late. They better start getting their hands on him.
Second and 20. Stafford with a screen pass intended for LeSueur. Right now that play isn't working very well. And Evans defending.
It's heads up football by Fred Evans. And we ought to point him out. He's in there for LeTroy. Guy on today. He's played well. He's danced well too.
Lions need 20 yards and they're 0 for 7 on third down conversions today. Stafford incomplete, overthrowing his receiver downfield, which was Calvin Johnson, and it was Brian Robinson who came on up the middle on Stafford. Fourth down coming up, and the Lions will kick.
And there it is. Antoine Winfield was listening. Get hands on him. That disrupts the rhythm of the route. And then look at 3-4 Vikings. They know where the Detroit Lions are going. Nice job by Minnesota's defense.
Marcus Sherrills with a fair catch. And the Vikings will have the ball. 13 to go in the fourth, leading by a touchdown. Vikings have the ball, first and 10. A reminder, coming up next, America's Game of the Week, Cowboys and Eagles. Desperate game for both teams. Some of you will see the Rams and the 49ers. Right here, we have a typical NFC North intense battle. Lions have won 3 out of 4, and the Vikings trying to end a two-game losing streak. First and 10 from the 25, and the pitch to Adrian Peterson. Peterson sees a little room. He has a first down. When he sees the opening, does he put the charge on? And a first down to the 43-yard line, getting 19.
Well, like I was telling you at the break, they should run on first down. Just joking. I said maybe pass on first down. But when you got that guy, it's hard not to give him the football. Adrian Peterson, they change it from the inside run to the outside run. Maybe see a weakness there. Again, you give him a hole, he's going to do some damage.
John, did you ever consider why you're up here? 20 rushes, 82 yards for Adrian Peterson, going over 1,000, which he did earlier. And a first down at the 44 of the Vikings.
Ready?
And the whistle. And we're going to delay of game penalty.
Penalty remains first down.
Boy, talk about momentum stoppers.
Hard to win in this league, and when you make mistakes like that that are unnecessary, that are foolish, that are careless, it really hurts. You put yourself behind the sticks, and that's really tough.
Seventh penalty called against Leslie Frazier's crew. It's going to be a battle in the, perhaps the toughest division in football the rest of the way. First down and 15. Here's Peterson with a burst. Peterson, first down. Peterson, he's going to go all the way. Touchdown with the high step.
We talked about limiting Adrian Peterson. They've been doing a nice job, but it was a matter of time. He broke the big one, and could that be the play that breaks the back of the Detroit Lions?
61 yards. By the way, Chris Houston, Lions cornerback, is shaken up way back at the 35-yard line. There's Houston. And this has been a depleted Lions secondary, but what about Adrian Peterson now with 143 yards?
Real subtle adjustment on that drive, too. Before it was the inside drive, now they go to the outside drive, and there's Adrian Peterson.
And you talked about single game rushing record, second in the NFL in rushing. What a brilliant career he has had, and we are continue to be amazed at how he has defied ACL recovery standards coming back from injury. He was injured on Christmas Eve and coming in today leading the NFL in rushing and going over the 1,000 mark. Today he averages 6.8 yards per carry.
And just take a look at this. You give him a little, he's going to take a lot. He sets him up with his eyes. He goes inside, and then he comes outside, and then it's a race to the finish line, and Adrian Peterson's going to win that one. What a tremendous player. He tears his ACL, missed essentially a game and a half. That's all he missed. And he came back, we all thought, too soon. But he's proven that he's not normal.
Hardly. And the two stars we've talked about, Adrian Peterson and Calvin Johnson, both have put on a show today.
Yes, they have. You can try to limit it. Easier said than done.
Blair Walsh on for the extra point. And the Vikings, who are used to giving up 30 or more points in their losses lately, have 31 to their credit. And it's 31-17 with 8:06 left. Well, in honor of Veterans Day, for every point scored during the NFL's 32 Salute to Service games, the league donating $100 to each of its nonprofit partners, the Pat Tillman Foundation, USO, and Wounded Warrior Project. To join the salute and learn more, visit NFL.com/salute. And for more on this special day, let's go down to Jennifer Hale.
Well, Dick, if you'll notice today, each player's helmet features one of five decals representing the various branches of the military. For instance, Lions corner Jacob Lacey is wearing the Army decal. That's in honor of his grandfather, Cain Balls, who served. Dick.
All right, Jennifer, thank you very much.
That's really cool. You know, Jared Allen, the great player, does some great things off the field. Friday night, he had his big gala that supports the Wounded Warrior Project. Tremendous effort by guys like Jared Allen, but more so by the men and women of our military.
Salute to service written in the back of the end zone. Banners, pylon decals, and the words backing up what these great men and women have done for this country. Lions will begin from the 20-yard line, trailing 31-17. And, John, you've got to really credit the Minnesota Vikings, because just when the Lions seem to be closing it, remember we said it was a 10-point game and a 6-point game, they have answered Detroit scores.
Exactly. That's what you have to do. If you're going to get punched, you better punch back. And you think they might be a little shorthanded, but they went to their great player, their number one player, Adrian Peterson, and it paid dividends in that last drive.
And we temper all that by telling you, with 8:06 to go, there is plenty of time remaining. And a first down at the 20 for Detroit. Joint Bell is in the game as a receiver out of the backfield. This is caught by Calvin Johnson. He's not done yet. And he loses the ball. Fumble. And the Vikings may have recovered. And now the official comes in saying down by contact. The Vikings, they do have it. A case in which the officials got it right. Antoine Winfield ended up recovering the fumble.
First down.
Sanford knocked it loose.
Sanford does knock it loose. That ball's loose right there. Good call by the officials. The ball eventually pops loose. Minnesota ends up on a tremendous play by Jamarcus Sanford. That's his fourth forced fumble of the season.
And only four teams have lost more fumbles than the Detroit Lions coming into this game. So we saw the official coming in from the top indicating down by contact, overruled by the official who was right there. So the Vikings have the ball on the Lion 45 after the 20-yard catch by Calvin Johnson. No surprise here. Adrian Peterson. And he gets to the 25 where Ricardo Silva makes a big tackle and a gain of 21.
I want you to watch this blocking. We talked so much about Adrian Peterson. Look at Matt Khalil. Kick out on Kyle Vandenbosch. You give Adrian Peterson that much room, he will do damage. Matt Khalil having an outstanding season. A rookie left tackle. They drafted him in the first round. Adrian Peterson really getting hot.
And we talk about simplifying the game, trying to limit them. Well, neither Gunther Cunningham nor Al Williams have been able to limit the two stars, Adrian Peterson and Calvin Johnson. First down at the 24. And here is Peterson again. And Peterson getting to the 23.
Jim Schwartz, the head coach of the Detroit Lions, made a great point about Adrian Peterson. He said he's like a quarterback. In terms of quarterbacks, we talk about them manipulating the defense with their eyes, looking off defenses. Well, he looks defenders off when he's running. He looks like he's going to the left. He comes back to the right. It plays havoc on a defensive player. Believe me, I've been there.
Rare for a running back.
Yes, he's rare.
Second down and 8. Vikings looking for the score that would nail this one down. And movement in the line. Maybe a defensive offsides. We'll see.
Encroachment. Defense. 5 yard penalty, remains second down.
5 yards against the Lions.
And that's something that's a common theme for the Detroit Lions. That's their 14th offsides penalty of the season. Number one by a long shot in the NFL. I think that's undisciplined.
And there is a tough blow for the Lions. Chris Houston, the linebacker, being carted off. They play today without Delmas and Spivey, their starting safeties.
Ready.
Peterson knocked back. Forward progress, maybe no gain on the play. A loss of one with under 6 minutes to go in the fourth as the Vikings trying to get the score that would put away the Detroit Lions, something that has been very hard to do today.
It has been. See Adrian Peterson, not uncommon for him to go over 100. I think they were happy with the 102 in week four. You saw in this second half the long runs got out, and that's what's beat them. I think you really have to credit Bill Musgrave. The subtle adjustment, instead of running inside, the outside plays have been the ones that have busted open for the Vikings.
Third down and 4, and they're going to go to a good thing. Adrian Peterson, he'll be a yard short after picking up 3 yards. And talking to Jim Schwartz, he said, you know, the one thing about Peterson, the longest run he had against us was 18 yards, but he kept them in check for the most part until that 61-yard touchdown burst. Fourth down and 1, and Blair Walsh, who has kicked 3 field goals, will try to make it 4 for 4 with a 33-yard try.
And the strong-legged kicker Blair Walsh out of the University of Georgia adds to the Viking lead. 34-17 with 4:36 remaining. And this Wednesday on Fox, the X Factor is all new live. The judges have had their share of disagreements about the top 12, but your opinion is the only one that matters. Your vote decides their fate. The X Factor, true talent, raw reality, this Wednesday and Thursday on Fox. So in the NFC North and the Minnesota Vikings looking for their sixth win in 10 tries and trying to overcome their two-game losing streak. And of course, they just came in just one game behind the Green Bay Packers.
Detroit's got to really fight, because you look at the end of their season, they've got 5 of 7 at home, but look at who they're playing. They're playing the Green Bay Packers twice. They're playing the Chicago Bears, the Atlanta Falcons. It does not get easy. Indianapolis Colts and the Houston Texans. Tough schedule for Jim Schwartz and the Detroit Lions.
Their only road games are against Green Bay and Arizona, but the way it's looking, they will wind up losing both games to the Vikings. Logan will see it go out of the end zone for a touchback. So you mentioned the Detroit Lions, who have two games left against the Packers and one against the Chicago Bears. And this is a team that lost to the 49ers by 8, lost to Tennessee in overtime, lost on the road to Chicago by 6. The division games are marked in yellow.
Howie Long said it at halftime. Disappointed. Disappointing season for the Detroit Lions thus far. We'll see if they can battle back.
First and 10 for Stafford, and the slant to Calvin Johnson. And Terry Bradshaw in the pregame show, he was maybe the only one who thought that Ponder would come out of it today. And how about 24 for 32, 221 yards and 2 scores?
He's played very, very well. Very impressive. He needed to assert himself. I think that's exactly what he's done.
Here's Joint Bell out of the backfield. And he's wrestled down before he gets to the first down by Chad Greenway. Gets 8 yards with 4 minutes remaining in the fourth.
The key for the Minnesota Vikings right now is make them earn everything they get. Those dink and dunk plays, you can live with that. Come up, make the tackle. Do not let them over the top of you.
Second and 2, incomplete to Pettigrew. And right now for game break, Kurt Menefee.
Well, just a not-so-gentle programming reminder that America's Game of the Week comes up when you guys are done. Most of your audience will see Tony Romo and the Cowboys against Michael Vick and the Eagles, both teams 3-5, so something of a survival Sunday for each squad. The loser, by the way, gets forked by Jimmy Johnson. Vick and John.
I don't think anyone wants to lose now, right? Third down and 2 for the Lions. And this pass caught by Pettigrew in a first down. Pettigrew catching the touchdown pass for the Lions earlier. And they have a first down. That's their first third down conversion of the game in their 9th try.
I mentioned it before. You don't go to a prevent. You don't want to get soft. You want to stay aggressive, but keep the ball in front of you as a defense.
Down by 2 touchdowns. And going underneath again to Joint Bell. And Bell with another first down. And is dropped in Viking territory at the 43 by Aaron Anderson, or Henderson, that is, and a gain of 12 on that play. Stafford again going underneath to Bell, and he's wrestled down by Henderson.
This is the time that guys like Jared Allen, they feast in situations like this. When they're in a must-throw situation, a guy like Jared Allen, this is where he can do damage.
Lions have 2 timeouts remaining. And the 2-minute warning, and there's Titus Young, who caught a touchdown pass earlier in the game, gets hit as he makes the catch by Harrison Smith, 11 more. And now the Lions are on the Minnesota 30-yard line. Stafford lost this, and Pettigrew can't wrestle it away from Josh Robinson.
Clock stops at 2 minutes and 10 seconds. It'll be second down and 10.
It's tremendous athleticism from Josh Robinson. He goes 5'10". Pettigrew goes 6'5". But he's right up there with him. Great play by Robinson. He's played well today at the cornerback position.
And he has had to defend Calvin Johnson for most of the day. Second down and 10. Pressure coming in. Stafford on the run. And he completes it to Calvin Johnson to the 11-yard line, where Smith makes the tackle. And the 2-minute warning is upon us. A 19-yard gain. Lions need a touchdown and an onside kick. It's been a big day for Adrian Peterson. 168 yards, including a 61-yard touchdown for Minnesota. They lead. They're trying to hang on. A reminder coming up after our game, the Pepsi Game Break Show. First and 10 at the 11-yard line. Calvin Johnson, who has 11 catches, tying his career high, looking to break it. And here's the pass, and he does break it to the 5, and Calvin Johnson goes over for the touchdown. Gets the ball over the plane, and the Lions get the touchdown, and Jim Schwartz says go for the one-point kick. 1:53 to go, and the Lions still with 2 timeouts left.
Well, believe it or not, only his second touchdown of the season for Calvin Johnson, but great job. The safety's over the top, so get him the ball and let him do the damage running the football. And then the long arms extending. He extends from the 3-yard line and gets the ball over the end line. Special player that guy is.
You know, John, that's his first touchdown catch from Matthew Stafford this week. The other one was from Sean Hill, the backup in week 3 against Tennessee. Jason Hansen for the extra point. And the Vikings trying to get a piece of that one. Don't. And it's now 34-24. And the Vikings have to be expecting the onside kick.
You've got to be expecting the onside kick. Detroit has 2 timeouts, so they could potentially just play defense. But the way their defense has played and the way Adrian Peterson's going, I'm not so sure I would chance it. I believe the onside kick's coming.
10-play, 80-yard drive, and Calvin Johnson with 12 catches, a career high for him, 207 yards, and a touchdown. So a huge game for the superstars. Peterson with 168 yards rushing and a 61-yard touchdown.
And Mike Prefer and Leslie Frazier, Prefer the special teams coach, they've got all the good hands people out here. Guys like Harrison Smith, Kyle Rudolph. Front line's going to block. It's Rudolph. I believe that's Michael Jenkins getting ready to receive this football.
Ball must go 10 yards, and here is the pooch kick. And it'll be picked up by Sherrills. And he goes out of bounds. And the Vikings will take over. The Lions will have to use their timeouts on this defensive series.
Not only use your timeouts, you got to stop Adrian Peterson. And Christian Ponder, he's been effective in his own right today. You really have to hand it to this kid and to the entire offense. Leslie Frazier kept this group up. Bill Musgrave came up with a good plan. They're without Percy Harvin. They come out and execute, but you got to finish right here.
Ponder with 221 yards at paltry yardage in the last 2 games. A lot of questions about whether he could still be the man. He answered that today. Handoff to Adrian Peterson. Peterson gets out to the 35-yard line, a gain of 2, and the Lions will call their second timeout. Well, we mentioned the Vikings still very much in this race in the NFC North. In fact, they have, as we look at their remaining schedule, 2 games against the Bears and the Packers, so they could do damage on their own after their bye week, which comes up now.
And the bye week comes at a good time because you've got a guy like Percy Harvin. Like I said before, maybe a good deal for Christian Ponder today not to have Percy Harvin, but you need him back. You want him back to play the likes of the Chicago's, the Green Bay's,
all of these Houston. Tough schedule for both teams moving forward.
But John, as you've said, to get out of the slump, he needed that whole offense and a lot of different targets. Second down and 8, and here's Adrian Peterson. And Peterson, no gain on the play.
Third and final and team timeout.
The Lions will use their third and final timeout.
And the gist of the theory was, you don't have your number one guy, you can't lock in, so go ahead, lock into his replacement, Jarius White. They came out aggressive. I like it. And then you knew you had to use the play action pass. Christian Ponder doing a nice job using his legs as well, spreading the football to different players. Rudolph had to come alive. He has thrown it to 10 different people today, including himself. Christian Ponder's played a fine game.
How am I going to get to double figures with receivers?
Well, when in doubt, throw it to yourself.
Throw it over Abel, I'll catch it. Meanwhile, Rudolph had a career high with his 7 catches today. Play action for Ponder, and he slides and gets hit as he slides, and the flag goes down. Got hit in the head as he obviously slid, and it was Sammy Hill and Ricardo Silva who came in on Ponder.
You see, when you slide head first, you give yourself up at that point. Can't hit him.
Personal foul, necessary roughness, late hit, number 91 defense. 15-yard penalty, first down.
So it's on Hill. And they'll mark this ball just shy of the midfield. And Titus Young and Calvin Johnson. Plenty reason to smile today as the, well, not as far as the result, but as far as what they've achieved offensively.
Calvin Johnson, he's all about winning, and he gave his best effort today. 12 catches, 207 yards when you're doubled and tripled throughout the game. One fine football player, one fine competitor.
Lions can't stop the clock. And we'll have time now for a game break, and let's check in with Patrick O'Neill. Patrick.
All right, Dick, thanks a lot. Atlanta, New Orleans, a chance for Matt Ryan and the Falcons broken up. Ryan trying to hit Roddy White, Jabari Greer, great defensive play, but the Falcons have the ball, and about under a minute left. We'll see if they can come back in this one, Dick and John.
I want to remind you, coming up next, our Pepsi game break. That show is coming up after our game. And of course, remember, America's game of the week. Most of you will see the Eagles and the Cowboys. And on this Veterans Day in Minneapolis, Matthew Stafford and the Lions couldn't keep the momentum going. They had won 3 of their last 4 and will wind up losing both of their games during the season to the Minnesota Vikings, who have dropped a couple. Every team has their slumps, but the Minnesota Vikings will go to 6-4, and the Lions will drop to 4-5. Dick Stockton, John Lynch, Jennifer Hale, so long, Vikings over the Lions. Right now, let's send it to Kurt Menefee.